The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi, folks, we're back. Basil Chapman, Tiger Technician's Hour, just at the TFNN 12 o'clock noontime Eastern update, and I forgot to post the charts, but here are the charts. Let's do this again. You see on the left side chart here, you've got the Dow daily, middle you've got the weekly, on the right you've got the Chapman Wave notation in the monthly chart. The daily chart has the left side, right side price time match that says if there's a break into the anywhere into the 27,000s in the next couple of days, you can expect some kind of a rally towards the all-time high. I think we're in a choppy sideways move at this particular time, just a congestion phase. Didn't want to go short, even though it was a leg D and was in this ChapmanWave inside track. Remember this technique that I use, ChapmanWave inside track repellent zone, that red dashed line, break above the green line, close above it sharply. That's very positive. We just stuck right up against it, but the MACD is very strong. Stochastics at 93%. Actually, the stochastic at 93% and the MACD strong should have taken the Dow very quickly into the 27,100s. So far, this is saying yes, that ChapmanWave Automotive, let me just show it here. I'll give you, this is a technical show. Let me give you the technicals. So the technicals that I was looking at that said Dow has a strong series of resistance levels. Look at this, from the 26,814 level to the 26,997, there is a ton, four different separate ChapmanWave automated resistance lines in the daily. 26,848 in the 10-minute chart, 26,972 in the 120-minute chart, and 26,653, 26,653 is key support in the 120-minute chart. That's the only support level we've got. If 26,747 breaks. So this is going to be very important. Now, what's also, I think, very significant is that in the weekly chart, it's way up at the 28,000 level, 27,127, and then all the way up there that you've got your resistance points are way down at the 24,630, 24,650 area is the support. So we're in the middle of the range. So let me just go through this quickly. The doji candle said if there's a close from yesterday, if there is a close under yesterday's low of 26,762, and we're about 28 points above it now, then there's a really good chance that we're going to go down a little deeper. It also says if there's a close above yesterday's high of 26,900, I would put it at 26,935. If there's a close around 26,935, 135 points higher from where we are right now, this up move should just continue nonstop. Even though there's a lot of resistance, it could just bump right into the highest level of the resistances. All right, enough with that. S&P is the same sort of thing, but it's a slightly different chart because it went to a peak E yesterday. Let me just type this in and make it red. And that should have at least a little bit of a pullback, because if it breaks to the upside with this particular pattern, yes, there could be a ChapmanWave instant restart, be an unconventional restart, but let's not get into that at the moment. Just to say that above 29.93, 97, that area, once it gets to that level, is a real quick, easy spike to the 3000s. I think there's going to be a bit of trouble here, just short term, just kind of stuck, needing a breather. If you look at the QQQ, the NDX 100 is down much sharper, is down $1.47 at 189.72. That's down 0.78%. That's the biggest percentage out of the indices right now. And that says to me that you're filling in the gap. You haven't filled it in completely. If you were to fill it in, you'd have to test the high of the 4th, which was at 188.89. So I'm looking at this saying, yep, digestive phase going on. And I mentioned this earlier in the update. Look, Boeing is giving a big spike. It's now up 8 at 366. And Microsoft, also in the Dow, I would say that Microsoft is certainly not a heavy-duty industrial, but certainly Boeing can become considered one. So Microsoft down 224 at 135, made an all-time high of 141, had a two-bar ChapmanWave reversal and peak F in the weekly chart. Let's see how this handles the next couple of weeks, because it does look like it wants to digest huge gains, been just a multi-year winner for quite some time, well, for multi-years. Okay, I wanted to just show you something in the IWM. The IWM right now is trading very nicely. It is, in fact, up $1.24 at 153.14 in leg C, just above the 200-period exponential moving average. I mentioned this to my subscribers to my opening call over the weekend. This, and I mentioned XLE, were looking very good. The IWM, just as a counter-trend rally, I know it wasn't sure it would be a real big trade, but as a counter-trend rally, it's turned into a very nice trade for those who were looking at it positively. XLE, I would not have got it yesterday because of the gap up, and today we had another gap up. We had a whole series of gaps to the upside. So it could be just about to run out of steam and have a little bit of a pullback at 61.36, up $1.14. But I would have to tell you, this is very nice action, especially when I looked at so many of the oil service, et cetera, stocks. And I showed this chart over the weekend, how it held this support, long-term uptrend, monthly chart support beautifully in the ChapmanWave inside track support level, propellant, and it's really gone towards the 200-period moving average in the monthly chart. That is very important. And that's in the 62.60s. And the weekly is way up at 68.45. I don't think that's in the cards right now, but 63.45, the 200-period orange 200-period moving average in the daily is in the cards. IYT, how's that doing then? IYT is up very nicely. This is the transportation index, up $1.80 at 191.48. This is a brand new leg, B to the upside. ChapmanWave methodology, identify the lowest, most obvious lowest low one in the 174s, and goes to the first peak is right there. Second leg, because it hasn't made a peak yet, as long as it makes higher highs, this continues the floating letter B, and this is very important. And this is, in fact, a buy mode. I've now got a buy mode in the transports, in the daily chart, not the weekly, although the weekly has the potential for a cup formation after the H pattern test of the low. So I'm watching the IYT very closely. I like this action. And a couple of things that I'm looking at that I would have to consider is important is this. The TLT is down $1.10 at 142.09. Just the other day, it was at 148.90. So 6 points, that's a big move down. Most importantly, if you're looking at the IYT, and that's the REITs, IYR. IYR is the U.S. REITs, the real estate index. And these are all REITs, and they're made up of a whole bunch of them. The one that we had that we got in the 135s. So this is a peak F now in the IYR. It's in a sell mode in the daily. Hasn't yet even given a sell signal in the monthly. And that's the reason why I said we want to hold on to a part of that position of the CCI, which is Crown Cork and Seal. REIT in the towers business down 3.85 at 139.63. It's gone from 149 to today's low of 138. That's, 138. And that's 139. That's 18 points in just a matter of just less than a week. That's a big move down. So, yes, we've taken nice profits on the way up. You still have a cool position.
If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS profile scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hi everyone, Basil Chapman. Yes, Tiger Technicians Hour, 877-927-6648. So I was mentioning the REITs come down sharply. Look at the TLT. The TLT is down $1.16. It made a peak E, and I suspect that this is going to be a little bit longer duration before we get back to the very low yields. I'm not sure. I had a message say it could be, this could be a crash or the bond market really starting to take it on the chin. I don't think we're there yet, not if there's this international deal going on where countries all around the world are just almost fighting to get to sell their bonds, and that's pushing yields lower. As long as that's going to happen, I think America could steady up right now. I can take this question mark away because it's now in a sell mode daily. Not yet anything in the weekly, but yes, in the daily. So yeah, I'll keep an eye on that. And believe me, I'm not averse to saying anything is going to crash if it's going to crash. I just don't see anything right now. I don't see any need for anything like that. But at the same time, I just wanted to show you, talking about, I said I'll be going on over the next couple of months. I'm going back into this coda phase and looking at what is very important. So have a look at this, if I can find it now. Okay, it's not there. I think it's this. Here it is. An email talking about the concept, BMW concept car. To me, this is not a concept car. This is just, I didn't mean that. Okay, got it. Okay, this is a new BMW. Look, it's two-door, it's very sporty. Look at the front grille. That's the big thing they're making a photo. Of course, they make, for people to take photographs of the very thing that they're trying to display, and then have the color of the car in the wrong color. Have a black background, and then you want a red car? You want to show it off? Make it silver or something. Yeah, okay, it's a little bit better now. Still not great. You see this huge grill? Now, you remember, I've made a big deal about this for ever since I've been here at TFNN, but as long as I've had subscribers to any one of my subscription newsletters or my services for mutual funds and the big clients like that, I've always spoken about the period of 1969, where the grill, the back and front grill of the car, weighed about as much as half the car and cost to replace about at least a third of the car. And I said, whenever you get into that phase, and we saw that in 2000 when the Cadillac Escalade, I used that as a prime example of excessivity, just a huge box that was gussied up with accoutrements, 200 cup holders. This is the kind of thing that American company auto companies have always done, instead of getting some kind of wonderful engineering like in 1955. Those cars are still classics today. You look at one of a Ford Thunderbird, it's just an incredible machine, and it has leather seats. It has all the stuff that came on later. Now, of course, you've got electronics. The electronics has changed everything. So I don't see anything here that makes this a spectacular car. Yeah, it's a great looking car, but this to me is not the top at all. This is just set up the rear. It's just, it looks like a I was going to say Oldsmobile. It looks like what is that? Not a Navigator, but I think it looks like a Lincoln. Yeah, it has the Lincoln back. So there's nothing very special here. I'm sure the car's great. Oh, look at that. That's a General Motors. That's an American automobile company thing, where you've got the lights right across the whole back. There's nothing here. It's like the complaints I've always had about the Tesla S model. There are so many things that could have made it just the most special looking car, as well as just the most special car, which it was. I mean, there's no question about it. What I'm saying is that I just don't think this does it, and this doesn't make a market top for me. Okay, enough with that. Let's get back to the nitty-gritties. So we're looking at bonds. I go to bonds themselves, and bonds right now are down $1.1.1030 at 161.21. Looks obviously like the TLT, but it made a peak G top and is in a sell mode in the daily. Nothing yet to speak about in the weekly chart. We'd have to wait for Friday. And it was only a leg C. There's no other way I'm going to count this. Leg C in the monthly, January, July of 2016, it hits 164.5. Of course, this gets smoothed out, so 164.5, it might be the wrong price, but it's absolutely the right chart pattern and absolutely the right peak. So the high that was made in July 2016 goes down to the low that was made right there, October of 2018 at 133 and 27.30 seconds, and runs in one big move. Well, it's three moves, three monthly peaks. Well, this is still legs, so it's only a leg C. And I suspect we will get a peak in September, going in October. We'll see. The month is young. And meantime, this is a spectacular move. Doji candle at the top. So this is going to be a little bit more serious than just 1 week. I think we've got a little bit of a problem here. So I just wanted to talk about that within the context of within the context of a down move. The MACD is still very strong to the downside, and the stochastic is now 38%. I don't think we're going to make any kind of a bottom until we get to between 22 and 18% as an initial bottom, but it could even go lower than that. And the technicals and the weekly charts are still pretty good. So let's keep an eye on that. Next question I had was, could I look at... the XLE I spoke about earlier in the update. XLE is trading very nicely, up $1.17, 61.38 S&P Select Energy Spider Fund. The daily chart is a very strong, it is in a buy mode, and it should go to a D. It's gone to the left side high. That was the target that we had right here at 61.89 in the analysis I did over the weekend. And I should have just bought it. It looked great. I didn't buy it. Just missed it. Yeah, I had a couple of misses. You know, I talk about what we got right. I do like to talk about what we got wrong, just because it explains what I do for subscribers. I gave a whole series of buys. One was plug. Look at this. I missed it by a few cents yesterday. I love the chart. This is plug power, hydrogen power, fuel cells. We missed it. I wanted to buy it. And okay, there. The low yesterday was 226. I wanted to buy it under 223, missed it by 3 or 4 cents. And now it's at 249. I mean, that's a big move. And look, leg B in the weekly chart. This is really nice, trading at $2.49, up 16 cents. AKS, we had a $2.22, got stopped out. And lo and behold, we're going to actually stop that, just very briefly stopped out. But then it went quite a bit lower. It went down to 2.08. And now it's at 263. So we've had a couple of misses that are really upsetting, very frustrating. I could go through others, but in the meantime, I talk about screamers. I've had a bunch of screamers on my list that just showed up over the last couple of days. Some have done really well. I'm thinking now that I'm going to add a little say. I don't know if I, it's just another, it's like another newsletter. I keep adding these things and taking so much time. But I will try to add a screamer or two every now and again. And what it says is, you've just got to get in. Close your eyes, put in a stop. And if it hits and takes off, we've got 2 days in which to get in and out. And it should be a 5 to 7% gain. We'll see. This is up 7%. AKS just today alone. I'll be back in a moment. Basil Chapman, Tiger Technicians Hour. Dow's up 1, S&P's down 6.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. I was just asked about a stock. I'd never seen it before. MUFG. What is it actually? Oh, this is a Mitsubishi. I didn't even. I've always wondered if there's a. MUFG. Thank you, Mitsubishi. Good. Because I have air conditioners from them, and they are fabulous, quiet as a mouse, and just great. Okay. So, all I said is for this particular person, it's trading at $5.12. The low just a couple of weeks ago was $4.62. It's a screamer. It's exactly what I'm talking about. A, B, in leg C in the weekly chart. It gaps up. Yesterday, it closes at $4.95. Today, it gaps up with a low of $5.09, and it's trading at $5.12. So I said, for this particular person, yeah, you could grab it right here. And I gave him a very tight, I said, buy a small with a 5.03 stop. If it hits 5.16, raise the stop to 5.08 and just ride until Thursday or Friday. It's a screamer, and this is what I'm talking about. Let me just go through a list. BBX, whatever the heck BBX is, BBX Corporation. Look at this screamer. The last 3 days, this is where I saw it, and I put it in the list yesterday. Didn't get it. I didn't put it as a buy. I just showed them the name. And look at this. It goes from the 458 area. It's trading right now at 498. CHS. Oh, is that Chico's? Yeah, Chico's Fashion. Look at this, a screamer. It goes from a low of 2.39 on the 28th. It has basically only green candles. This is still leg A, and it's at 4.01. This is what I call screamers. CLD, I thought this was Keldor, the famous sculpture. 9/11, up 35. Look at that screamer. CPG, this is not Calper, it's Clouders, I've never heard of them. Crescent Place, or Crescent something, Crescent Point Energy. Look at this screamer. Now at 4.05, just the other day it was 3.73. I mean, DACT, D-A-K-T, I remember this from a while back. What is it called? Dactronics. Look at this. Gaps up the other day from the 6 area to the 652, and now it's trading at 772 in leg D. I mean, I could just go on and on and on. FRO, F-R-O. What was Frontier something? Yeah, Frontier Limited. Had a beautiful, now it stopped at 8.99. This is what's going on in this particular market. You've got a bifurcated market. You've got the IWM up 1.93, up 1.27%. The Dow is unch, and the S&P is down 0.24%, and the QQQ is, at this point, down 0.52%. When you get a mixed market like this, it means that portfolio managers are starting to look elsewhere. Schlumberger. Look at this. There's a screamer for you, 37.87. Well, I like them when they're in the single digits. Look at this, in leg C, a big move off the low. It could be short selling, could be anything. It doesn't matter. It's the velocity, it's the speed, it's the ferocity of the move. But it's going to be the momentum in the weekly chart that either sustains the move or makes this one of those rogue waves where it washes out very quickly, and then it starts all over again. But at a much lower level. Look at this. I'm going to go to. Why are the brokers doing so nicely? Ameritrade, TD Ameritrade, up. Look at this. Also a screamer in a leg C. Good grief. Who would have thought when the market's mixed like this to down, broker stocks are doing very nicely. Here's another one, BGCP. We once had this as a stock in the portfolio. BGCP, let me type it in the right place. BGCP. Oh my, just look at that. Just the other day it was at the 4.15. Now it's at 5.56. No, 5.59. Right at the 200 period exponential moving average. Something's going on. and it is a delayed reaction. It's a delayed reaction to something, and now money is finding its way into the low price stocks. Usually this is the tip off that something else is going on in a phase that says we're getting tired of the Amazons getting smacked. I mean, look at, talk about getting smacked. Look at the stock that I use for subscribers. We've used it as a harbinger, as a harbinger for MKTX. MKTX, just look at this. I was going to short it the other day, but shorting a $300-something stock, I mean, even though it's down 20%, oh my, it's even more. Just today alone, it's down 25 points at 343. Made a peak F top at 421.45 on the 6th of September. I mentioned that it made a doji candle with a round number low. Watch out, getting very toppy. Makes a leg F and then a peak F at 421.45. Kaplop, this is Market Access Holdings, Inc., MKTX, trading at 343.78, down 26 points. Electronic trading platform in the credit market. Where's the credit market right now? In a heap of trouble, just shorter term. Look at this. We gave back a month's worth of trading in just two sessions. That's usually not a good sign. So this is a very mixed market. TDOC for S&P in the Dan. Yep, this is another one, also in leg C. Look how many of these are in leg C to the upside in such a quick move. 64.46, except if it was $6.46, it would fit the screamer category. So this is more just a very good rally, up $1.53 at 64.40. Teladoc Health. Oh, I like that. There's certain sectors in the healthcare that I've been pinpointing for subscribers that are in the cost reduction area. So whatever happens politically, they're the ones that could be under the radar. It's a matter of, yeah, look at that. I had this one as a buy the other day, and then I decided I wouldn't put it as a buy. We just had too many other things that seemed to be working, and that's Agilent Technologies, Inc., spectroscopy solutions, improved method of development. Had a big, one of the great winners, went to $82 after a spectacular couple of years, and it goes to 80, then it drops down to 63. That's a $20 pullback, 20%. Starting to move very nicely. I like the way it was breaking this ChapmanWave inside track repellent line and zone, broke out of it, closed last week above it. I like this. There were too many other stocks that I was looking at. So, Agilent, A is a symbol, trading at 74.36, up 18 cents. Another one that I thought I'd just take a quick look at is, I wanted to do the XAL. Is that starting to move nicely here? Yeah, this is another one. This is the same pattern we've been seeing all day. I've been showing you these charts with a very good move from the low that was made 2 weeks ago. It's gone from the 89 area to 97 and just a really quick move to the upside and a very quick move to the downside. But I love to see the airline index at 97.54, up 92 cents, doing the job. That's very good. Dow's down 3, S&P's down 7. Basil Chapman, Tiger Technician's Hour. Take your calls at 877-927-6648. Whoa, what an interesting market. I'll be back in a few minutes.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
If you're a trader in the market looking for exposure to gold or gold mining equities, then now is a perfect time to sign up for Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. The summer is over, gold is trading back above $1,500, and the 10-year treasury is hovering at around 1.5%. Tom O'Brien has been writing his weekly gold report for almost 18 years. There's no one that knows more about how the gold market trades and how gold mining equities react. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, Tom publishes his weekly gold report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, the dollar, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. As of September 3rd, Gold Report subscribers have 5 active open positions with an average unrealized profit of almost 38% for each position. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up today by visiting TFNN.com. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foresight Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
So let's just have a look at Teladoc. Obviously, Teladoc Health means that they must do something over the telephone or telecommunications. Made a peak in the weekly chart at about 74, pulls back to the 54 area, and now it's trading at 64, up $10. And you can see this is a pattern that I like to look at in the just pure chart formations. You go from the top, it's like a flagpole, and I always put the rectangle in, and then I say, in a shorter time frame, you should get a Chapman wave. If the left side low holds and starts to make higher highs and higher lows, it should go to a D in a shorter time frame. In this case, that's a monthly chart we're looking at. So we're looking at the weekly, which did that exactly. It went to a peak D, Chapman wave methodology. Let me just quickly do this for those of you who are not used to it. Three patterns, straight line up or down like this. It goes into an arch or a cup formation, or you get a combination. So three patterns or a mix. And the mix says it goes down, makes an arch formation, and then retests the left side low. If it takes that out, that's very negative. And the upside, green, because if it takes out the inverted Y on that left side high, if it takes it out on the right side, that's very positive. So just keep it as simple as you can. Always identify the lowest low and count at least four peaks to the upside, but you can go 5, 6, and 7, which is E, F, and G. But it's at the fourth one, peak D, that other things can. They don't have to, but they can happen. And yeah, you got your big pullback at a peak D. Yeah, you went all the way to an F, the sixth highest peak, plummets down, and now you got the inside buy mode, Chapman buy mode, and that is working out so far. You saw it in the daily. So this move off the low that was 54.58 on the 28th. Type that in, 54.58 on the 8/28. I like this very much. And this is a Chapman wave squash between, so S&P and the Dan, if you're listening, the MACD and Stochastic and the daily have produced what I call the Chapman wave squash. It says very quickly, you've gone from oversold in the Stochastic under 20% to overbought, which is a good sign. Overbought means buying is continuing. Over 80%, it's at 86% in the Stochastic. The MACD has turned up very sharply with a commensurate move in price, and you've got that here, going from 54 to today's high of 65.07. It's in a buy mode. It should go to at least a D, and then it could pull back. But I like what I see, and if you're in it, I'm going to say keep holding. I like it very much. I would even think of adding. Just give me a yell if it pulls back at any point in the next 2 weeks to between 61.50 and 60.80. If it doesn't even get there, that's really positive. But if it gets there, let's do an analysis. So far, so good. And hey, good eye, a very nice trade. Next thing we were looking at is silver. I didn't look at silver. Well, let's just do gold again. So gold is pulled back sharply. It's in the rectangle. Remember, I said my suspicion is even if we go out to the upside above the 1546 level on continuous contract, that peak D, we could go higher. But my suspicion was we would come back, and if we came back deeply, we would even go down to the lower 1488, call it 1489. And test that. That was the low that was made back in early August. If you go under it, I suspect you'll come back to the middle part, or at least the 1510 to maybe 1515, and then maybe have another pullback, because this weekly chart says you need a little more time. You don't have to break down, but you just need time to the side. So that's what I'm looking at in gold. Gold is still an active participant in this mega bull market. And I don't see anything there that's changing. Next question. Oh, now let's go to silver. Silver is back in the, after that peak E top, it's pulled back right there. This is a peak E in the weekly chart. If there's no new recovery high above, I can't see how that's going to happen above 19.75. Let me put that in here, 19.75. Ooh, 1975, that was a good year, right? 19.75 on the 4th of September. So, yeah, silver's just also retracing that spectacular move it had. And all I can say is that the whole area that I've rectangled in here between 1750 and 1650, I wouldn't be surprised at the end of this consolidation if silver has retested the 17 level. $17.32, $17 level. It just needs time. It's had a fantastic move up, and it could bounce. It could bounce to 1853, and then maybe pull back again. Platinum, I was asked about. Yeah, platinum is trading. Same thing. Now, I call this a C, but I'm going to make this an E slash C in the Chapman wave alternative count. Have to type it in. Why? Because all the other metals have pulled back, and it went to a leg D and looks like a peak D in the weekly chart, and that looks to me very strong, but it also says it's a little too extended and that it needs to consolidate. So I'm just saying play it safe for now. Pay a palladium. Palladium is trading very nicely up 1.39 and 147.16. I was asked if I could quickly go through the grains. Here we go. W is up very nicely. This is wheat. Up 5. At 479.5, just about hit the 50-period exponential moving average. You know, I think this can go to 481, and if it holds above that for 2 days, what will happen is that the 464 to 472 area should become very strong support. That's what you want to see. It's not how far can it go now, it's how does it hold any – oh, look at that move in soybeans. 13.5 up 871. I like this. It's still in the chop, chop, chop sideways, but the MACD and stochastic have improved tremendously after this trough F. 871.5 up 13.75. Oh, if this can get to 883, another 12, 13 points higher in the next two sessions, that'll say turn around, watching a TRCCI. That is the, type it in the correct place, mister. TRCCI, that is the Thomson Reuters Equal Weighted Commodity Index. Oh, it's starting to rally a little bit. Good. That's the first decent sign we've seen in a while. So trading at 389, up 230. I like it. It looks very much like some of those patterns that we've been looking at all day. Very sharp move off the low of August the 20, whatever that is. Let me just double check the date. August, the low was right there, on the 23rd of August at 374.63 on the continuous contract. Oh, now that is the TRCCI, Thomson Reuters Commodity Index, equal weighted. Nice action. I think it's making some kind of a tradable bottom. Home Depot. Home Depot is now down 6 at 232. Hey, this is good action. This is my cash index. So Cintas is looking terrible. Cash. I just typed in cash. Oh, make a note of that. I did recently. I said, hey, cash looks very good as a stock. Cash is, isn't this the Meta, what is it called? Meta Financial Group. Ah, so Meta Financial Group, very nice action at 32.66. Serendipity plays a part in looking at stocks. It's up 0.83 at 32.66. Hey, I like this. I'll do a little bit of work on it during the break, and then we'll look at my cash index. Cintas, Amazon, Spy, and Home Depot. I'll be right back.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. Today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. This is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge heard here at TFNN.com.
All right, we're back. Yeah, so cash, C-A-S-H. This is Meta Financial Group in Inc. Yeah. And it's in leg E in the daily, a leg D in the weekly, and the monthly is improving a lot. Oh, this looks very good. Getting a little overbought, but actually very nice at recovery highs. Hey, that was good. Anyway, Cintas. Huge down move. And this is what I was saying to subscribers. We've got some of the stocks we were looking at were fantastic And then they were making topsoil. I said, now you got to be careful. Syntas is one of them, down 643 at 249, had a 270.36 high on the 20th of August, pulls back sharply to 255, and then runs to 270.24. How many times this year have we seen V-shaped patterns that have gone back to within pennies of the all-time high? This one just took days, but we've seen that happen. You know, I can't remember the stock, right? Was it Disney? One of those. Did it? No, one of them went right to within pennies of the all-time high and then had a V-shaped pullback. So let's just go through this. Amazon is trading down 7. It's just stuck. Remember, I said Amazon's stuck, and it's not such a good sign. SPY is still way under the all-time high. It's at 297. The all-time high was 294. Oh, can't be. 297. The all-time high was 302. Somewhere around the 302s. Well, I shouldn't say Sharpie, it's still underneath that. Home Depot is doing quite nicely. But wait a minute, look at the CME group. And this stock has been one of our favorites. We were going to buy a call on it at one point. It would have been fantastic. Would have, could have, should have, not the point. Point is, I said, let's be careful here. Let's watch it closely. CME makes a high of 225. I think it just missed it by a penny. 220. To 24.91, missed it by 9 cents, a round number high. And then what does it do? It has a little bit of a turn down, and in two days, it takes out and goes to today's low of 205. That's 20 points. That's a 10% correction in 2 days. And look at that weekly. The weekly hasn't given a signal yet, but it will by Friday if it holds down at these lows. So this is very important. Chicago Mercantile Exchange at 209.07, down 651. Hey, have a wonderful day. I will see you tomorrow. Stay tuned for Steve. Stay tuned for Dave. And, of course, Tom O'Brien. And check out my opening call, my daily newsletter. Yep, our Caterpillar is doing very nicely. Thank you.